The San Andreas Fault is a continental transform plate boundary that goes through approximately 750 miles of California. It's formed by the tectonic plate boundaries between the Pacific plate and the North American plate, and is constantly moving horizontally. Unlike convergent and divergent plate boundaries, which can create volcanoes and mountains respectively, transform plate boundaries don't create new land, but their movement creates friction. The fault is divided into three separate segments, each with their own degree of earthquake risks. In short, the San Andreas Fault is two pieces of the Earth's crust, constantly being moved by hot mantle coming from the Earth's inner core. However, they move at a rate as slow as our fingernails grow, and sometimes, they don't move at all. Originally, the fault was identified by Professor Andrew Lawson in 1895, who discovered the Northern Zone. In 1906, after the tragic San Francisco earthquake, Lawson concluded the fault actually extended through Southern California. This would lead to years of studies being conducted on the area, and of course, tons of questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer all those burning questions you may have. We've done previous videos regarding earthquakes and such, but today's question: what would happen if the San Andreas Fault actually ruptured? My name is Jared Bronstein, and before we get into this video, I want to know your thoughts. What do you think would happen if the San Andreas Fault completely ruptured? Would California ever be the same? Would it look like it did in the movie starring Dwayne The Rock Johnson? Let me know in the comments down below. And of course, share this video with a friend. I'd love to hear their thoughts as well. Following the 6.4 magnitude earthquake that shook Southern California on the morning of July 4th, questions started arising as to when the fault could cause another earthquake. Research has discovered that the fault consistently produces a 6.0 magnitude earthquake approximately every 22 years. Among these studies, one published in 2006 determined that the fault has reached a significant enough stress level for an earthquake of magnitude greater than 7.0 to occur. Not to say it will necessarily happen, but more specifically, the risk is in the southern section of the fault. In 1857 and 1906, the central and northern segments of the fault produced quite serious earthquakes. However, the southern segment hasn't produced anything as serious as the other two earthquakes in over 300 years, which leads researchers to believe we're due. So what would actually happen if the San Andreas Fault ruptured? For those of you that don't know, this inevitable earthquake is being referred to as the Big One. Now, before everyone starts hitting the deck, let me say, although scientists don't know when or where the Big One will happen, research is constantly being done to try and track it. Meaning, if something were to happen within, say, the next 5 or 10 years, we'd most likely know about it. But if it were to happen today, well, it would not be pretty. It's believed when the Big One does finally happen, the most likely scenario is that a 7.8 magnitude earthquake would start at the Salton Sea and continue all the way up through Lake Hughes. The largest possible earthquake that could strike majority of the San Andreas is of 8.4 magnitude. During the rupture itself, it's believed, to no surprise, unreinforced structures, usually made of cinder block or bricks, would ultimately crumble. Buildings with wooden frames would most likely last longer than those of brick or cinder block. However, those with underground parking, such as condos or apartments, would also crumble due to their inferior structure. And although a majority of the more recently built structures wouldn't completely collapse, they may be deemed unsafe to enter. Due to the fact that the San Andreas Fault is quite far inland, its rupture wouldn't disrupt the ocean floor, causing a tsunami like you see in the trailer for the Hollywood movie. Contrary to popular belief, LA also wouldn't be considered the new Atlantis either. It also wouldn't cause a big gap between the two plates because they're moving next to one another, occasionally knocking off rocks here and there, not being pulled apart. However, this rupture would cause casualties. Aside from those in buildings affected, it's believed the rupture would kill thousands of people, injure even more, and of course, misplace tons of people from their friends and families. As is usually the case, power and electricity would be the first things to go. Depending on where the fault ruptured specifically would determine how much power would be lost, but this could lead to wildfires as well, which would just make matters even worse. Aside from this, oil and gas pipelines would also rupture, spewing gas into the air, which could potentially ignite and cause more explosions. Water would also be scarce, assuming a large-scale earthquake would rupture some of the major pumps that help bring water into California. Ultimately, it would be a race against the clock to repair everything before the entire state runs out of fresh water. On top of this, the water that is available could also potentially be contaminated, making it unsafe to drink or use. However, the impact doesn't just stop once the actual earthquake itself is over. Aside from aftershocks, which usually follow hours or days after the main shock, the economy and people of California would ultimately have to deal with getting by and cleaning up the mess that would be produced from the rupture itself. Highways, roads, homes, and so much more would be completely destroyed due to such a high magnitude earthquake. According to research done back in 2008, in total, the effects would cost the state of California upwards of $200 billion. The research took into account four major categories: losses due to fires, destruction of lifelines and infrastructure, non-structural damages, and of course, damage to buildings, which is estimated to cost the state $33 billion alone. Now, before we start stocking our shelves with water and batteries and such, let me remind you, this is not expected to happen tomorrow. So don't worry just yet, guys. We got plenty of time to prepare. As always, we'd love to hear from you guys, so feel free to drop a comment down below on how you would handle the situation if the San Andreas Fault were to rupture. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, and until next time, keep questioning everything, my friends.